Hey guys, welcome back. In today's video, I might sound a little sick. I am still getting over a really awful cold. So I apologize if there's coughing. I'll try to edit everything out, but my voice is going to be a little raspy, so bear with me. Today, I wanted to work on some Christmas cards for family members, and I was really excited to use these detail brushes Arteza sent to me. I specifically requested to try out these detail brushes, and they insisted I tried out these new half-pan watercolors that include this water brush that's sort of like a little mini travel size. And so I decided I would just use both of these in this video. But I do want to mention that I was really excited to use the detail brushes since I do tend to use a lot of detail in my work, and I don't have a ton of super tiny detail brushes, and I really wanted to give these a try because I know you could do a lot with fairly inexpensive materials, and this set has a whole lot to choose from. But I will show you these watercolors. I am going to be using them, and I was intrigued by the little tin that these come in. This is a very similar tin to watercolor sets you can get nowadays from Prima Marketing and the Jane Davenport watercolors. And I also have my Schmincke Horadam watercolors in a similar tin to this that I ended up buying separately for pretty cheap over in, I believe I bought this in Germany, but I mean, you can get tins like this pretty much anywhere. And they are very, very similar. There's a ring on the back. There's little spaces within the tin itself that you're able to mix paint in. And the idea is it's a nice little compact set. You can mix and match your watercolors since the half pans do clip in and out. And so I did like that from Arteza that you're able to expand your watercolors if you would like. I know they do have a larger set of these. I don't think you can buy the half pans separately or individually. Here I'm showing you the comparison to the Jane Davenport. The Arteza watercolor tin is just a little on the thicker side, but it has all the same exact shapes for mixing inside the tin. The only thing I will say that I prefer about the Jane Davenport set is that the little mixing wells on the back part angled down a little bit. I don't know if you're going to be able to see it, but the Arteza one kind of angles upward, whereas the Jane Davenport one angles downward. And that just means that the water will stay in those wells just a little bit easier when you're mixing them. But these two tins are almost identical. They have the same mixing wells underneath the pan. I guess that's what they are underneath the paints. But I wanted to compare these just because they were so similar, and they are a similar price point. I'm not directly going to be comparing the watercolors themselves because that would be kind of unfair. These are a completely different color set and they're a different makeup, but I wanted to show you the tin because I really do enjoy the tin. It does hold all 12 of these. I know in my Schmincke set, I think I can actually push them over and fit just one more on either side, so that is nice, whereas these don't have that space. However, they do have the space in between the pans that you can fit paint, which I can't do with my Horadam set. So there's pros and cons to any of these kinds of tins, but I do like the general design of these similar tins, and so you're getting a really high quality product in that regard. I did show a close-up of the paints, and I will show another close-up in a sec. As you can probably see, there's sort of a weird texture thing going on with some of these paints. Overall, most of them are a little chalky looking, and as you could tell, the green one has a sort of strange metallic speckle on it, whereas the warm brown has kind of a lighter film on it. So I'm not really sure what's going on there. Here I wanted to show just the size of the half pans themselves compared to a Schmincke Horadam and Jane Davenport. So these are all the lemon yellows. So you actually get a lot more paint. I get, maybe not a lot, but a little bit more paint than what you would get from the Schmincke, which those are professional grade, I believe hand poured in the half pans. And I bought the half pans themselves individually, whereas these other sets come with these paints. And with the Arteza paints, I could tell that these are not poured into the half pans. And in fact, this green color was not at all secured in the pan. I was able to fix that pretty easily by just wetting the bottom of the pan and sticking it in and letting it dry. It seems to stick pretty well, but that was something I noticed, along with sort of the odd textures on some of the paints. But on to the brushes. These are really springy, and they're not overly soft, and they don't, I don't think they hold a ton of water, but I actually really like that, especially for detail. I think it helps give you a little bit more control with the details you're working with. I wanted to quickly show you the different labeling of different kinds of ranges that Arteza has. So you can tell the watercolors are premium. The colored pencils I have are labeled as expert. And on their site, they also have supplies listed as classic and kids. I think the kids one's pretty self-explanatory. The classic appears to be maybe more for hobbyists or crafters. And the premium line, I believe, is supposed to be student grade, whereas expert is supposed to be professional grade. I believe that is what those mean, so keep that in mind. I think it's important to know who these art supplies are intended for. I am a professional artist, and I use watercolor all the time, and I tend to like to use something more on a professional range. But I wasn't always there, and I definitely didn't start there, and so I don't want to grade these watercolors to my current standard of what I would use when that is not who these are necessarily intended for. I believe these paints are definitely intended for someone who is maybe just getting started and wants a good solid set of colors that they can experiment with, and they didn't have to spend a whole lot of money to get there. Since we're swatching these out, I wanted to give you another close-up of the texture of these. It is a little on the thicker opaque side, as I wanted to show off. And the green that has those weird metallic speckles, I did want to mention that once I wet it and started using it, that didn't seem to affect the paint at all. I'm not sure if that's just, it was not well mixed or what happened there, but it didn't look metallic on the swatch, and that sort of dissolved. So thankfully that didn't seem to really affect the paint at all. These are definitely chalkier than some of the more transparent watercolors that I might use on a regular basis. But again, I know that these are intended for more students or someone starting out or a hobbyist. So keep that in mind. I know someone mentioned, I think it was Mira Beiler was mentioning that she really loves when pans like this, half pans, are not all wrapped up in plastic. Well, I enjoy that this didn't have plastic for me to take off of. I was frustrated that I felt like they weren't as well protected when they came to me. So that is something to keep in mind. You don't have to unwrap them, but that is a little bit problematic for some. As you can see here, you do get quite a lot of pretty blooming and texture with these paints, so I did enjoy that. So I ended up doing my sketch in Procreate. I've been really enjoying drawing digitally, and at least sketching digitally, on my new iPad. And so I decided I really wanted to do kind of a reindeer with some plants, of course, and some little ornaments hanging from string on the antlers. And I have a brand new toy that is a pigment printer that is an Epson, just a fairly small Epson printer, but since it does print with pigment ink, I'm able to print multiples of these images and paint these in different ways. So I thought that that would be a really good way to show you guys these colors, test out some different color palettes, because that's something that I do want to test out more and expand the colors that I use so I don't get real stuck in one particular type of color palette or paints. And I wanted to just kind of experiment a little bit with this, and I thought it would be fun to have three different originals that were painted on the same design. So that's what I'm doing here. For the rest of the video, it's going to be time lapse as well as some bits and pieces of real-time painting, but it's just painting these three and putting them onto some cardstock as my cards, as my Christmas cards for my family members this holiday season. So I wanted to talk a little bit about these brushes and paints, just a little bit more in detail while we finish out the video. I really, really like these brushes. I tried to use a variety of different ones. I ended up using the largest, I believe, round one brush for the larger places in the antlers and the deer itself, and some of the plants as well. And I tried to use the smallest on bits of the ornaments and things like that. I really thought that this would be a perfect test of super tiny detail brushes like this. So I didn't use every single brush, but there are like 15 in this set. So it's kind of a lot. And there's three different kinds of brushes. I believe there's round, liner, and spot. The round and the spot brushes seem very similar to me in terms of how long the bristles are and overall it being a round shape. And the liners are definitely a lot longer for details like that. So I don't think I'm gonna use the liners as much, but the spot and the round brushes, I think I will actually use quite a bit. And I think these are gonna be added to my regular rotation. I really like the quality of the brushes. I think there was one that I needed to trim just a little extra, few bristles that were just a little bit longer than the rest of them, but that is easily fixed by some small scissors. And so I really don't have any complaints about these brushes at all. They are synthetic, they're inexpensive, it's a nice large set, and I was really happy with them, and I'm really happy to add them to my arsenal of painting since I do a lot of detail. And yeah, I'm excited to add even more detail to my pieces now using these brushes. I did want to quickly mention and apologize that I have quite a new setup that I'm putting together, and hopefully things will come together a little bit easier in the new year. But as you can tell, I have a different backdrop. I have kind of an interesting angle. I'm in the middle of replacing a tripod for my camera, so this was a bit of a strange angle for me to work with than normal. I don't know if you can tell, but I have a brand new camera that I believe was on autofocus and I didn't really focus it on the painting itself. So it does go out of focus when my hand is too much in front of the camera, and that is something I will be focusing on more for the future so I can really make sure everything is in focus. The camera is really fantastic for vlogging and I'm excited for that, but for purposes of paintings and things like that, I think I need to mess with the auto focus feature just a little bit more. So in terms of pros for these paints, I will say that the colors activate with water pretty quickly, and the tin itself is really high quality and is a really nice size and up to the same quality as a lot of other sets that are comparable with this one. I do like the selection of colors in this, aside from me always wanting some sort of good purple in these kinds of sets, which that's okay. I think it gives you a good range of different colors. I think the one thing I would say about the color range is maybe having a warmer blue that wasn't super light. So a good solid warm and cool of every color. And I feel like the yellows were both on the cooler side, whereas it would be helpful to have a warmer color if you're going for a set that has a sort of classic range of colors for getting started, which I do suggest a set like this for someone getting started, maybe a student, depending on what kind of projects you're using it for, but for a crafter or general artist. I think these would be just fine for learning watercolors and testing things out. I feel like they layer just fine. I didn't put a lot of layers in these pieces, but I do feel like they worked just well and you get some nice textures from them. So they just are a sort of basic quality that is not something that I would normally gravitate toward now in my watercolor career, but I think for someone starting out, it could be helpful. I will caution that I think the other sets that are comparable to these in size and range of colors are around the same price points, and I might suggest going with something a little different, especially since these don't seem to have any light fast information or pigment information. You're getting some pretty basic paints. So shop around and see what the prices are. If this is on the cheaper side, this might be something you want to go for. But with that being said, I really love the detail brushes, and I am so thankful for Arteza for sending these out to me. Quick reminder that all the supplies are listed down below and they are affiliate links, so if you want your purchase to help out this channel, I would be super grateful. That's it from me. I hope you enjoyed this video and this fun deer card design. I hope you have a creatively fulfilled day, and I will see you in 2019. Bye guys!